Today, I want to highlight an application called Canta. It's free, open source, and can be downloaded directly from F-Droid or its own GitHub page. With Canta, we can uninstall bloatware system apps without needing to have root access. However, Canta does require that we have Shizuku set up ahead of time. So if you aren't familiar with Shizuku, or you would like some help with setting it up, then please check the video description below for a dedicated guide that I have here on the channel that will walk you through the process. Basically, Canta is going to execute the ADB commands to remove pre-installed apps that cannot be deleted through normal means. However, with Canta, we don't have to execute those individual ADB commands since the application will do that for us in the background. But before I can show you how that works, we first have a word from today's sponsor. PlayStoreSales.com is a website that I've been working on for close to 10 years now. It highlights the best Android apps and games that are currently on sale in the Google Play Store. And you'll find some great Android games that are on sale, like Bendy and the Ink Machine, and even Minecraft. So please go check out www.playstoresales.com and tell me what you think down in the comments section below. So as mentioned, we do not need root access for Canta to work, but it does require you to have the Shizuku service up and running. And again, check the link in the video description below if you need help getting that set up on your device. With Shizuku running, we simply need to load up the Canta application and then begin looking for an app that we would like to uninstall. Now, if we look up here at the three-dot menu icon, you can see we have a Show Only System Apps toggle that we can enable. And it's from here that we can select the removal type. And this leverages the Universal Debloat List badges that has been established by the community. So usually I recommend you only go through the recommended apps, since the other ones can be a bit iffy. I have used the advanced list in the past on a HyperOS device from Redmi, and uninstalling everything in that list resulted in a boot loop. So blindly following even just the recommended list may not be ideal for all devices. Just be aware of what you're trying to uninstall and definitely create a backup of your important data ahead of time. So today, I'm going to be using the calculator app as our example. You can see it has the recommended badge, and I am unable to uninstall it as I'm only given a disable option. So we're going to go into Canta, find the calculator app, and then we're going to select it by tapping on the box next to it. Then we're going to tap on the trash can icon in the bottom right corner. It's going to confirm if you want to uninstall that app. We're going to tap on OK. And if this is your first time using Canta, it's going to ask you to grant it access to Shizuku. So we're going to grant that access. And you should see a badge at the bottom saying uninstall complete. And with that done, you can see we no longer have the calculator application installed, so it will not show up in the home screen or in your app drawer. And that's because it has been uninstalled from our device. Now, when we go back into Canta and we check out this uninstalled tab up at the top, you can see we have the calculator app. So you can use this to restore your previously uninstalled apps in case you decide to use them at a later date. If you have some bloatware that you would like to remove from your Android device, then I highly recommend you check out Canta if you are familiar with setting up Shizuku, because it's quicker for those who do not like to mess with ADB commands.